in October 2008 on a very cold, windy afternoon, Saturday afternoon, looking down Bridge Street in Stokesley, North Yorkshire. Stokesley in the 19th century was now known for its publishing and printing industry, and one of the most interesting publishers lived in the house to the behind me at the townhouse. The name was Tweddles and Sons. Although not commercially very successful compared with the other printers in this area, he's still probably better remembered than many others. He came here in 1871, and his wife is probably well known as Florence Cleveland. Her name, real name, was Elizabeth. One of the interesting publishers and printers in Stokesley in the 1870s was George Martin Tweddle. His office was in the townhouse that you can see behind us. We are standing in a location where four of the most important aspects of this company can be seen. The office, which we can see here already. To the right of us is the shop in which much of the money that served the printing was earned. A very general store. It had stationery, books, wallpaper, toys, teas, coffees, tobacco, snuffs, spices, and many other things. And above it, their son, the son, Horatio John, and his family lived as their compositor. John worked in the print office that is in the, was now demolished. And now originally could be seen in a small building to the left of the pizza place. Perhaps the rest of our story would be better be told inside the office, which the owner has kindly allowed us to film, and perhaps we should warm up a little as well. Standing in the office of Tweddle and Sons. Behind us, we can't see it because it's now been substantially changed, is where all the equipment was kept, the paper, the books that were published here. And above is the resident area where visitors, guests had many pleasing evenings, conversation with GMT, George Markham Tweddle, as we know him, and Elizabeth, his wife. George Markham Tweddle is fairly well known and still mentioned in the Stokesley Trail. May I read a bit? George Markham Tweddle lived here in the 1800s, a man of many interests, poet, historian, publisher, printer. author. He was also a stirrer up of controversy. The explanation for the controversy really goes back to his young days in Stokesley, where he's very enthusiastic supporter of the Chartist organisation.
They've been modernised too, haven't they?
This, the Broadacres estate is the same as ours.
I don't know the precise one. It may have been down on the window.
Thank you.
Stokesley.
Yeah, the other one. RCC for the
right. It's too loud.